Today we're having a look at Tucking in Sea of Thieves. If you're new to the game or a returning player, you may have heard of this term as it's quite a popular playstyle. If you're not sure what it is, then this video is here to explain how you get going so you can have a go yourself. I stream Sea of Thieves on Twitch every Tuesday and Thursday at 7 p.m. UK time, so if you want to watch me fail miserably at Tucking, then give me a follow over there and drop in the next time I'm live. So what is Tucking? Tucking, being tucked or getting your tuck on, is a playstyle in the game that is essentially hiding on another ship or a location such as an active fort, then going undetected so you can then plan an attack or a steal, relay information back to your crew, or carry out a god tier play with a mega keg as they roll into an outpost full of loot. Streamers like to do the tucks, as it can add a lot of tension to the gameplay, can result in some funny situations emerging. It's also a different way to play the game. It adds a bit of variety, so if you're bored with the standard PvE and PvP, it'll be very rewarding if you pull it off, but it can also be very boring if you took on a newbie ship that isn't up to much. In those cases, you're better off just giving the newbie a heads up, tell them about Tucking, tell them to watch this video, and let them go about the day. So how do you do it? There's a few things you'll need to tuck successfully. First, the shape of your pirate will help. You'll want a short and skinny pirate, so bear that in mind when you're selecting your first pirate. If you already have a big pirate, you can head to the Pirate Emporium, purchase a tincture to change your pirate appearance. This costs around £2 or $2, so keep cycling through the pirates until you find a short and slender one. Next is your outfit, so lose the hat and pick some dark clothing. It's not essential, but it will keep you a bit more hidden when tucking in daylight and stop the larger clothing items from standing out of chests and kegs. You'll also want to lose the boots, so here you can see an example of what it sounds like when you run around in boots. Against running around barefoot. So losing the boots will help you stay a bit more stealthy when you're boarding ships. So if the crew's downstairs and you're running about upstairs trying to find a good spot, they won't be able to hear you, so it'll give you an advantage when boarding the ships. Now you'll need the hide emotes. So these are actually used to do the tucking and put your pirate in various positions to help them blend into the environment. Hide inside chests or kegs and make them tuck in and small enough so that you're hidden from the field of view. Again, in the Pirate Emporium, head to the pirate section. Find the hide and seek emote bundle. The best one is free, so you can get that for nothing. If you've got a few quid spare, I recommend buying the full bundle and have some fun trying out the other ones. Any of the emotes with the word hide in are the tuck emotes, so while you use these will hide your gamertag from the view of other players. If you're on an enemy ship, your mermaid will now disappear as not to alert the crew that they may have a tucker on board. I recommend adding these to your emote wheel in an easy to access position so you don't have to scroll and hit the wrong one by accident. So set up a trigger shortcut if you're on keyboard. On controller, I have the main tuck emote at the top of my wheel, so it's easy, just down on the D-pad, up on the right stick to activate it, and on keyboard I use the shortcut Z3 for that emote, so my hands don't have to move far to trigger it. So now that your pirate's ready, it's time to practice. Have a play around with the different ship styles and get used to boarding and getting in position. Also have a practice tucking into kegs and chests, as there's positions that work better than others. Once you've got the hang of it, found a few that you want to try out, go and find some ships to board and give it a go. So that's it for this short video. Please drop a like and subscribe if you found it useful. The channel is mainly geared towards streaming advice and Sea of Thieves, so if you're into either of those, stay tuned for more content. See you in the next one.